Well, new developments tonight in the rape trial of former Colts player Josh McNary. Today, the woman accusing him spent 2 hours on the stand testifying about what happened to her last year after the Colts beat the Redskins. And as RTV6's Derek Thomas reports, she used social media to try to tell her friends she needed help.
The alleged victim said that while she was inside Josh McNary's apartment, she sent several Snapchat messages. Those messages were closely scrutinized. She sent the message via Snapchat at 3:13 a.m. The message with a picture simply said, "Save me." However, the alleged victim did not provide any information about her whereabouts if someone wanted to save her. In actuality, she was in 27-year-old Josh McNary's apartment at the Block Apartments located at 50 North Illinois. On the witness stand, she said, "I was feeling uncomfortable, but I was okay with it." She worked as a manager at Kilroy's and the night was filled with alcohol consumption. She had vodka drinks, Jaeger bombs, and tequila shots at the pub on Georgia Street, Blue on Meridian, and finally at Tiki Bob's, where she met McNary. She was with two friends at Tiki Bob's and they encouraged her to leave when they left, but she stayed and left with McNary. According to her testimony, when they got to his home, the pair kissed and made out on the couch. She told him she was dizzy and needed to lay down. She went and laid down in his bed. They resumed kissing on the bed. Eventually, they had sex. She said she doesn't remember how her pants or underwear came off, but said, "I was saying no," verbally out loud. The defense questioned her sharply about conflicting testimony before, during, and after the alleged crimes. Forensic nurse Sarah Hines testified that the alleged victim did sustain injuries to her left ear, scratches to her right arm, bruises to her left thigh, and swelling and abrasions to her genital area. Under cross-examination, Hines admitted that the presence of injury does not mean there was non-consensual sex. The defense promises some medical testimony of its own. It will attempt to rebut testimony from the prosecution's witnesses. Derek Thomas, RTV6.
And police also tell us the woman left McNary's home in a hurry and took his phone. It helped them track down who she was involved with because she could not remember where he lived.